Have you ever tried to use incremental refresh on your Power BI report and the data is coming from AWS Athena through ODBC connection, but you couldn't do it because query folding is not enabled? Hello everyone, Xiaobis here, and today I'm going to talk about an issue you may face, the query folding issue when you import data from Athena through an ODBC connection. In this video, I will show you how to solve this issue. Please like and share this video because it can help many of you who are dealing with incremental refresh. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and get notified with the new upcoming videos. Stay tuned. Previously, I created a video on how to enable native query in Power BI. That approach is working for most SQL-based data. But sometimes you see even after applying those steps, native query is still disabled, and you'll get blocked for the incremental refresh. If you are interested to know more about incremental refresh in Power BI and learn how to set it up, you can watch this video in the channel. It's highly probable that you are using an ODBC connection to bring the data from Athena or even directly from Athena. And when you want to apply incremental refresh, you will see this error message. That means the query folding is not available. And so, you cannot apply incremental refresh. In this video, I'll show you how to easily solve this issue. First of all, open the Power Query Editor. As you can see, I loaded this table from Athena through an ODBC connection. And here if I right click on it, unfortunately the native query is not active. What I'm going to do first is duplicating this table to keep the original one unchanged and create another one to apply the changes. Similar to many other reports, what we need to do is filter the specific date time column based on the range start and range end parameters. This is a thing we need to do when we want to use incremental refresh. So, in this example, the control load date is our date time column that we are using for the purpose of incremental refresh. And then, I need to filter this field based on the range start and range end parameters. But as you can see, after applying the filters, if I right-click on each of these steps, you can see the native query is inactive. And so, we cannot use incremental refresh and we'll receive the error message I showed you at the beginning of this video. So, as I described in this video on how to enable query folding, I'll change the mcode to see what's happening. And now I press on done to see if the issue is solved or not. But the issue arises here, and you can see we received this error and our table crashed. This might happen when we are connecting to Athena and especially through ODBC connection. But don't worry, if it's the case, we still can solve it. And here is the solution. First, I remove this duplicate query and start from scratch on the original one. This time what we need to do is instead of creating another step to filter the control load date column, we apply the filter inside the SQL query. In this approach, the incremental refresh is working even if the native query is disabled. So let me open the advanced query editor, and here at the end of the select statement, before the quotation I press enter for 2 times to move it to the next lines. And here in this line, I use a where class to filter the data inside the SQL query. Then I write the name of the date time column, which is control load date, and it should be greater than or equal to range start parameter. But the query here is a little bit more complex. And if I simply insert range start, the query again will be failed. So I write open parenthesis, select date, and be careful to insert these three characters exactly to what I'm writing after it. I pause for some seconds for you to focus and not make any mistakes. Then I write dateTime.toText and open parenthesis. Be careful about capital letters here because M is a case sensitive language. Then inside the parentheses, I write range start, comma, and then the format which is yyyy-mm-dd. And again, I need to close whatever I open in this line. So again, I write these characters and pause the video for some seconds for you to copy exactly the same as I write and then continue the code. Okay, now what I'm going to do is to add the second condition. I add AND here and then copy all these code and paste after AND. The only thing I need to do is to change this operation to less than and change the parameter to range end. And it's all what we need to do. Press on done and wait until the table gets loaded. Now the parameter filters are applied inside the query. And if I close and apply these steps, the table will be loaded to the dataset. Just notice the native query is still disabled, but we apply the filter inside the SQL. So the incremental refresh should work. Now if I right click on the table and choose incremental refresh, you can see we haven't received any error. And easily we can set up the rest of the features for incremental refresh. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and share it if it was useful for you. And subscribe to the channel to get the notification for the new upcoming videos. You can also read Power BI articles on my blog and connect me through LinkedIn. Have a good day, all Power BI lovers.